Welcome to the Odds Breakers, the number one place for shared, sharp betting information.
Welcome back to Podcast 51 of 2024. I'm your host, Kiev O'Neill. You can follow me on Twitter at OBKiev. Follow us at The Odds Breakers. Follow us on social media / The Odds Breakers. This episode is being brought to you by the season for the largest football contest entries in all of the land. Please visit the SZN.com/OB for an extra $10 off your bundled contests. There's over 10 of them in their package. Terms, conditions, and location apply. If you'd like to support the Icebreakers and benefit from our premium plays, please visit the Icebreakers.com, click shop, become a member, pick any of our winning cappers to get their premium plays before the line moves. You can also support us on patreon.com. If nothing else, please visit the Icebreakers and become a free picks and Telegram subscribers. Also, remember to use the promo code FOOTBALL24 all the way through August 15th to get $100 off any of our football packages or half off any of our monthly packages. All right. We have a great show for you today because Vegas Matty is coming back to talk about the Circa football contest and how you can get in from anywhere in the world and participate in the Circa Millions, the Circa Survivor, as well as the Westgate Super Contest. Great stuff from Vegas Matty. We talk about overlays and all the great situations that could give you positive EV. We also are going to talk some preseason football, my friends. Preseason. I've been very profitable over the past 5 years in the preseason, except last year was the year I wasn't profitable. So I just wanted to throw it out there that I did have a slightly below positive preseason. I was in the red, not by a lot, but I think over the last 5 years, I'm pretty confident that we're going to have another great preseason for 2024. So just wanted to make sure I'm full disclosure out there. But some of the ways that I bet the preseason is through coaching motivation. And that's what today's show is going to be about before Vegas Matty comes on. Preseason football for the NFL. The Hall of Fame game is this week. The fun has just begun. NFL is back, and so is football. It's about time, my friends. And I can't wait to talk about these coaching motivations with you. Let's get started here. It is very important in the preseason to think about this stuff because you can definitely beat the preseason. There is obviously still luck involved, just like in any sports betting. But coaching motivation is the number one thing to handicap in these preseason games. As we know from previous years, some coaches are very motivated to win preseason games, and some coaches are not. Although some coaches are very motivated to win and get their team ready to getting to the winning category in certain preseason weeks. Sometimes it's week one, sometimes it's the middle weeks, sometimes it's the last game where they want to start feeling the W's. So that's important too, and we track all of that. And this article is going to be coming out on Tuesday morning so you guys can digest some of this. Obviously, listening to this podcast gives you a jump on everything because I'm going to go over it anyway. And I really appreciate you listeners out there. It's great hearing from you, and I like to hear some of the angles that you might have for preseason. But for now, this is mostly about coaching motivation. There's other things that factor. New coaches tend to want to win from the get-go. New quarterbacks usually tend to want to get their feet wet in the preseason. A lot of times you'll see these rookies get a lot more reps than the veterans. You know, so you're basically a rookie going against maybe a number two quarterback, but you also have to make sure that number two quarterback isn't pretty good himself. You know, I'm not super excited to go against Tyrod Taylor. Just letting you know. Okay? So all this information is key, but right now we have many coaching changes. That's key as well. And we actually have data on the three coaches that coached before that are brand new to 2024. There's eight total coaching changes. Five are brand new coaches. Eight are guys that have coached in the league before and have enough preseason data for me to make an educated decision on. I say about eight games is what I need to really start thinking the sample size is getting big enough for me to make these decisions on if these coaches are motivated or not in the preseason. The five new coaches that have never coached before are Brian Callahan of Tennessee, Mike McDonald of Seattle, Gerard Mayo of the New England Patriots, Antonio Pierce of the Las Vegas Raiders, and Dave Canales from Carolina. They have no coaching experience, so usually when they have none, I think these guys usually try to hit the ground running. Unless they're facing somebody that's been there that has a proven track record in trying to win the first week of preseason. The three coaches that have experience are Raheem Morris through Atlanta. And Raheem Morris is 5-7 in the preseason. And then you have the LA Chargers, Jim Harbaugh at 10-6. He, kind of like his brother at 63%, likes to win more than lose, even though they're considered meaningless games. 63% for Jim Harbaugh. And then finally, Dan Quinn. Dan Quinn from the Washington Commanders, 6-15 in the preseason. Although he did go 2-2 his very first year at the Atlanta Falcons, his last 3 years were 1-12. So, have to consider that. So, those are your new coaches coming in for this year. With the good, we have to also have to remember the bad when a money-making coach leaves or gets fired, like Pete Carroll, who had a nice 57% winning percentage in the preseason at 28-21. And then we had to say goodbye to Brandon Staley, who was 33% at 3-6 in the preseason. He was just getting to the trustable factor of fading him in the preseason. So, unfortunately, you also lose some of those coaches. And Bill Belichick was usually a nice play-on coach in certain weeks at 56%. You know, may the gods bless them with more coaching opportunities. So, I'm going to quickly blow through these coaching records for you and let you know if the sample size is big enough to trust. Arizona, Jonathan Gannon, 2-1, 67%. Not big enough of a sample size. Raheem Morris, 5-7, 42%. That's big enough of a sample size. Just a little bit too close to 50% for only 12 games. John Harbaugh, 44-14 at 76%. Huge sample size. And you know John Harbaugh loves to win the preseason, although last year he only went 1-2. Maybe it was because the whole Lamar Jackson contract situation might have threw him off a little bit. Sean McDermott from Buffalo, 14-8, 64%. That's definitely a big enough sample size. Dave Canales hasn't coached yet. Matt Eberflus, 4-2, 67%. Not quite big enough of a sample size for me. Zach Taylor, 3-9, 25%. A big enough sample size to start fading Zach Taylor. Kevin Stefanski from the Cleveland Browns, 5-4. 56%, big enough. Dallas Mike McCarthy, 31-32 at 49%. Too close to 50, but definitely a big enough sample size. Sean Payton from Denver, 30-33, same deal, 48%. Dan Campbell from Detroit, 3-6 at 33%. He looks like a fade. Green Bay Packers' Matt LaFleur, 5-8, 38%. Looks like a fade. DeMeco Ryans, only 2-1. Shane Steichen from Indianapolis, only 2-1. Jacksonville's Doug Peterson, 11-12 at 48%, too close to 50. Andy Reid, 45-47 at 49%. He's hit or miss. LA Chargers, Jim Harbaugh, 10-6, 63%. He's a play-on coach. Los Angeles Rams, Sean McVay, 7-14, 33%. Definitely a fade coach. Las Vegas Raiders, Antonio Pierce, 0-for-0. Miami Mike McDaniel, 2-for-4. Not a big enough sample size at 33%. Kevin O'Connell, 0-for-6. Getting closer and closer to being an amazing fade coach and possibly a moneymaker. He hasn't won a preseason game in 2 years. New England Patriots, Gerard Mayo, no games yet. Dennis Allen from the Saints, 7-for-11 at 39%. He's a fade coach. New York Giants, Brian Daboll, 3-for-3 at 50%. Not big enough. Robert Saleh, 7-2 at 78%. He likes to win in the preseason, and this sample size is now big enough for me to start betting on Saleh in these situations, especially if he's going against one of these fade coaches. Philadelphia's Nick Sirianni is only 1-for-6, but you have to remember he has had two ties over the past 2 years in the preseason. So, you know, you can almost call that 3-for-6, but still, I mean, 14%. I feel like Sirianni likes to win kind of at the end of the game, and he's not going to put his starters in, but he's going to try to hype his team up. Pittsburgh Steelers, Mike Tomlin, 41-for-20, and an amazing 67% at a huge sample size. So you got to love that. Tomlin, definitely a play-on coach. Mike McDaniel from Seattle, 0 games. San Francisco's Kyle Shanahan, 11-for-10, 52%, too close to 50. Tampa Bay's Todd Bowles, 9-for-13 at 41%. That's in fade territory. Tennessee's Brian Callahan, 0-for-0 at 0%. And Washington's Dan Quinn, 6-for-15 at 29%. Definitely a fade coach. And some of the most, just to summarize, winning coaches that'll be paying our bills. Mike Tomlin, 41-for-20 at 67%. Schedule, schmedule, I'm on a 9-1 preseason run. Robert Saleh at 7-2 at 78%. Rodgers didn't get hurt in the preseason, so there's that. John Harbaugh, 44-for-14 at 76%. Please forget about last year's 1-2. Lamar wasn't happy. Some of the most losing coaches who will help pay some of our bills. Nick Sirianni at 1-6 at 14%. No tush push needed to lose meaningless games. I did, however, tie twice. Dan Quinn at 6-for-15 at 29%. I'm coming back to lose, baby. And I'm going to consider that for the regular season, too. And Zach Taylor at 3-9 at 25%. No way can Joe play. No way. There's also a lot of up-and-comers, like I said, with Kevin O'Connell at 0-6. And Dan Campbell, who is now fadeable at 3-for-6. So looking at the week one records, I think it's important to know some of these coaches that love to win week one. John Harbaugh is 15-1 in preseason week one. That is his best week. I'll be on John Harbaugh no matter what, even if it's a money line play. And I also want to remind you that these are winning loss records. And the reason I don't do ATS is because the motivation is the same and the spreads are really close as it is. So I just care about if these coaches want to make a push to win at the end of the game. That sometimes works and sometimes doesn't. But the ATS records are also very close to what these coaching records are anyway. So it looks like Sean McDermott likes to win 4-2 in week one. Not enough info quite on Matt Eberflus from the Chicago Bears yet. We have Mike McCarthy only 6-for-11 in week one, yet middle weeks 18-11. So he likes to win in the middle. A couple other key ones. Andy Reid's not great at week one, 11-for-15. But the other two weeks are profitable usually. Winnable for him, not necessarily profitable from a betting standpoint. Jim Harbaugh, only 1-3 in week one. So he's the opposite of his brother. The other 2 weeks are winning weeks for him. Nick Sirianni, 0-3 the first week. He seems to really not care in the first week. And then Mike Tomlin, he's 19-for-10 in the middle weeks. 11-for-8 in the first and 10-6 in the final. And he's got a great record, but he's probably a play-on coach throughout the whole time. And then the big key ones at the end are like Jim Harbaugh. The final week for Jim Harbaugh so far is 4-0 in the preseason. So he's the type of coach that's going to want to win his final week. And Sean Payton is 4-for-11 in the final week of preseason. So he's a coach that really doesn't care about the last week of preseason football. So remember that. Sean McDermott, 5-2 in his final week of preseason. So keep those numbers in mind. This article is going to be coming out on Tuesday morning, so you can get some more information. A couple last things. When there's a quarterback competition for starting, that's a time I want to be at that on a preseason game as well and on that team, because you're going to get really big efforts from these quarterbacks, and usually this score can be run up a little bit on the offensive side of the ball as well, so be careful with your unders, but I do like that. Also, the Bears number came out. They're minus 1.5 favorite against the Houston Texans on week one. You know, not enough information on DeMeco Ryans here for Houston. He did win his only first preseason game. Obviously, the Bears, not enough information on Eberflus quite yet. He is 2-0, though, also his first week. So he's trending in the play on for week one. So both of these could be play on coaches. But the total is 33. I'd be careful with that total. I'm leaning to the under just based on the trend. The Hall of Fame game, these teams really want to keep it simple, and they don't want to injure their quarterback. So usually it's just all backups in these Hall of Fame games, and they just want to get the heck out of Canton, Ohio. So keep that in mind for NFL preseason. But everything's going to be here in the article for you, so you can handicap the preseason with some help. Before we get to Vegas, Matty, I just want to remind you that we have a premium insider membership for only $50, and it's a guaranteed membership. If we're not profitable the first month for you, you completely get your money back, and you can cancel at any time. So you can try it out completely for free if we are not profitable. And even after that, we're going to be going month by month from the 1st through the 30th of each month, or 31st, whatever the month is. And if we're not profitable, we give you half your money back after that. So here at the Odds Breakers, we are dedicated to make you profitable in sports betting, and we are putting our money where our mouth is. Check out the Premium Insider Membership Package. You'll get your weekend plays every Friday. It's a consensus plays for our handicappers here at the Odds Breakers. And like I said, if it is not profitable, you get your first month money back. Now, without further ado, let's bring in our wonderful guest from footballcontest.com, Mr. Vegas Matty. Now, I'm very excited to welcome back the best proxy in all of Las Vegas from footballcontest.com, Mr. Vegas Matty. You can follow Matty on Twitter at Vegas_Matty. This segment is brought to you by Circa Sports. For the best contests in all the land, please visit circasports.com/contest for over 16 million in guaranteed prizes, getting Circa Millions and Circa Survivor with this guy right here. Welcome back, Matty. How was your vacation?
It was good. Yeah, nice to have a little R&R before things get crazy over in these sports books over the next 6 weeks or so. It's going to be nuts, and it's going to be another record signups at Circa, and we're going to try to help them help Derek avoid those overlays.
Oh, those nasty overlays. We don't like overlays. Well, actually, I'd like overlays, but he doesn't like overlays. Overlays are great for me. As a matter of fact, if I was the only one to sign up for this contest, it'd be pretty awesome. but, you know, that's not going to happen. But the truth is that there is a lot of overlays in these contests, and we'll get to that. But anyways, I suppose for any new listeners out there to the Odds Breakers, or anybody kind of just not completely familiar of what you do, why don't you talk about football contests and what you do for all of us?
Sure. Well, we run the leading proxy service in Las Vegas for the past 15 years. So this is going in year number 16. My partner, Toni, and I, we've been just racking up the numbers over the years, and this year should be even bigger and better than ever. So we're hoping to have a lot more winners. We had a Super Contest winner last year, Super Contest Gold winner. A lot of people cash in the Circa Millions. They pay out the top 100, so that's something you want to keep in mind. You don't have to, of course, it's awesome to win the $1 million, but there's a lot of other payouts that you can win. Basically, top 10 in the Circa Million and all get six figures. So that's pretty cool.
Absolutely, man. It's there's just so many little contests because it pays 100 spots now, and you have the quarterlies, which is fantastic. And if you have a terrible start, you can go for the booby prize, you know, and then just try to go for booby prizes here on out, or for the quarterly. I mean, quarterlies are still a good amount of money, 150 grand for first, right?
Yep, that's right. And I think it's $25,000 for a booby prize quarterly winners as well. So yeah, you stink it up for 4 weeks, 5 weeks, you can win get basically a decent chunk of change just for being bad. So it's hard to be as bad as you are good in some of these too. So like you said, the best thing is you get off to a bad start, you still can win some money. And if you get off to a great start, then you're in the running for the big money. But you had alluded to the proxy, so I totally blew that one off. But basically, we were responsible for submitting the picks in person for these contests. So you need to get to Vegas to sign up between now and the beginning of the football season. And then once these contests are underway, you need somebody who can submit the picks in person. You can, if you live in Arizona and you want to, like yourself, and you want to cross over the line and submit them on the mobile app every week, you can do that. Or you can hire somebody like us to do it for you. So, that's basically it. We're the middleman between you and the casino.
Absolutely. And that's what's great, because you can get into the biggest football contest in the land, like at the Circa, without even having to be in Las Vegas. That means from anywhere around the world.
The whole season, yeah. 18 weeks is a long time. It's funny, I think the Westgate actually had a promotion a few years ago where they would try to hook you up with a room deal, like free rooms if you were able to come out and you wanted to put in the picks yourself during the season. And that was a short-lived promotion, just because it's so much easier to use a proxy than to try to get to Vegas. I think one of our clients a few years ago, he was coming in from Colorado, and he flew in every week of the season because he didn't know a proxy was available. Now, this was over 5 years ago, so things have obviously changed. We've got our name out there quite a bit, so people understand the value of having a proxy. And when I heard that, and that he was doing doing a round trip flight every week just to put his picks in, I was like, that's insane. The costs add up, and just the time and energy you have to do that is crazy. You want to focus on picking winners every week, and that's what we want to provide, a stress-free experience for you. You don't have to worry about anything but just handicapping the games and submitting your picks every week.
Yep. That's all you got to worry about, and that's what's important. And you know what?
That's easy, right? That's the easy part.
It's the easy part that you shouldn't be stressing over all week, that all of us love to do, but that's what makes it kind of fun. You know, if you like betting, I mean, it's no different than betting. You already put your money down. You're just still making the picks. It's still exciting. You still have to do 4 to 5 week increments here to get the 150 grand. I mean, all for $1,000, it's worth it, you know, and that's what makes it so awesome. But are there any changes to what you do over there at football contest this year?
Not too much. We're just trying to, soup up the website a little bit more, help the performance of it, make it. I mean, we've got about 1,000 clients that we're trying to make sure that they can get their picks in an efficient manner, and the site loads okay and it's secure and all that good stuff. So every year we kind of do an audit and look through what we can improve a little bit better. And that's kind of what I'm trying to do now, a good 5-6 weeks ahead of schedule, so that once the season rolls, there's no issues. So we just want to have this whole thing run like a well-oiled machine, make it easy for you guys. And yeah, that's kind of what we're responsible for. So we don't want you to stress about anything.
Yeah. Great call. And that's important. No stress and make it easy. And that's what you guys do there. What kind of changes are with the contests here? Well, actually, before I get into that, which are the most popular contests, I should say, before I get ahead of myself, in Las Vegas?
Sure. Well, yeah, the big three obviously are the two Circa contests, the Circa Sports Million, the Circa Survivor contest, and then the Westgate Super Contest. So those are the three that we proxy for. The Westgate Super Contest used to be the granddaddy of them all, kind of started everything with the $1 million winners, things like that, back when they used to charge $1,500 an entry for that contest, and they had upwards of, I think their biggest year, they had about 3,500 entries in there. So you do the math, and that's a lot of money in the prize pool. So unfortunately, once the COVID year 2020 hit, they did not have a guaranteed prize pool. And when there weren't a lot of people that came out to sign up that year, it really, I don't want to say killed the super contest because it's still around, but it really put a hurt on it, because Derek Stevens over at Circa offered the $1 million, the $1 million winner guaranteed, and he also had a guaranteed prize pool overall, which for the Circa Million now is $6 million. So you know, you have the grand prize of $1 million, and then basically spots 2 through 100. They pay out ties and everything like that for that. That's the other $5 million that's in the pool. The super contest just can't compete with that anymore. They are relying on the number of entries, similar to poker, the number of people that are the number of entries that are in there. Now you can enter up to seven times in that contest. Very few people do that. But last year I think they had 1,100 entries. And I, like I said earlier, we did have the winner in that contest. He won a little over $200,000. The Super Contest Gold, which is a $5,000 winner-take-all contest, we had the winner in that as well, and he won like $460,000, I believe. Woo. So that's a whopper. I mean, that's a tough one where if you finish second, when we've had some guys finish second in the past in that, which is worth absolutely nothing. So you want that's kind of still a prestigious contest because it's a high-stakes contest. And the one cool thing about the super contest, I will say, is that there are 12 ways to win. In addition to the one overall prize, there's 11 other mini contests within the season. You know, Circa is known for their big quarterly payouts, but the super contest pays out every 3 weeks, every 6 weeks, every 9 weeks. So you end up having 11 smaller contests, like a first half contest, a second half contest, then every 3 weeks, like, you know, basically – you know, you got to go like 14-1, 13-2 to win that, and you don't win nearly as much money as you might win in the Circa Million quarterly, obviously, but you're still going to, be able to win some money, like, you know, $25,000. Right. It's nothing sure to sneeze at. So that's something you can play for. And a lot of guys who like the Pick 5 contest, because let's be clear, the Circa Million and the Super Contest are both Pick 5 contests against the spread. You have to pick 5 games. They have set lines, so the lines do not change. And you just take your best 5 picks, you put them in. And a lot of people will do one of each, like one entry of each. And I think that's what I know we'll talk about the overlays shortly. Yeah. But that's the challenge that Derek has with the Circa Million, is just trying to get people to sign up for the max of 5 entries in that one. Because that's really, you want people to sign up as for as many. One entry per person is not going to get to your 6,000 entries that you need to avoid the overlay in that one. Absolutely. You got to have people doing multiple entries, a lot of 5 entry max guys in there to be able to hit that, which he has not been able to do the last couple of years.
Well, when there's an overlay, the more entries to buy, the higher your odds go up for a positive EV experience, because there's no rake in the circuit contest. And, I love what the super contest did. And I was in it back when it was $1,500. But as soon as COVID hit, I missed year one of the circa, but I haven't not been in one since. So we're at year 6 in the circa now. And I'm excited for it because, you know, like you said, it's got the guarantee of 6 million. Any other changes, though, going on with the circa contest? I think that there's just more of a guarantee for sure.
Well, the guarantee actually in the Circa Million has been the same the last couple of years. So it's basically he's going for that 6 million. It's chasing it. He hasn't been able to hit the number the last couple of years. And he had like 5,300 entries last year. And again, that translates to an overlay of $700,000+. So the goal this year is to hit those 6,000 entries or more. And if there's more than 6,000 entries, the overage goes back into the quarters, so that those quarterly prizes will be bigger. So that's what everybody wants, except for down there, downtown anyways. They want to be able to go over 6,000 entries. It is nice to have bigger quarterly bonuses, but I know the players, that they'd be happy with keeping it like around that 5,500 level, just so that there's some positive EV like you're talking about there. But it is going to be a challenge because, you know, if you keep looking at the numbers, the Survivor contest is outpacing it more than 2-1 right now. And even if the Circa Million might be at a record pace, but what does that mean? Does that mean 5,700 entries? Does that mean 5,800 entries? Is it outpacing over 6,000? That's definitely a question for Jeff Benson over at Circa. He normally has the metrics on that stuff.
It's not even August, and it feels like it's pacing better than it has been.
I think the pace is definitely better, but it's just a matter of, will it keep up? Because those numbers for the Survivor is going to be about 12,000 entries, I think, without a doubt. Like, I think that's the minimum. If I was going to set an over under, I would say like 12,000, which is $12 million in the pot. You know, that's amazing. Now the million is another story. You're almost a sixth of the way there, heading into August, and you're good. Yeah. There'll be over 1,000 entries going into August, which is better than ever, I believe. But 6,000 is still a bit of a challenge, because normally, I try to look at the numbers and say it's going to be about, you know, 4 to 5 times the numbers you see going into August. And with Survivor, that's like you get to 2,500, then that 4 or 5 times is like between 10 and 12,000, the pace. You know what I mean? The million is close. But is it going to get to that 6,000? That's going to be tough.
You got a personal formula for that. Well, okay.
It's just kind of based on past experience. I mean, it's ballpark stuff. I don't have like a magic
ball. Oh, yeah. It's cool. It's good that you do. Like that.
But I always kind of try to look at anybody looking at the numbers going into August. You can at least quadruple them, if not like it's 5 times the amount.
Right. Me looking at it, I'm just staring at this 5 million overlay, just praying it stays the same. But of course, if it stays the same, Derek will never do this again. So there's no way that it's going to stay the same. But I think you got past 5 million last year in entries. So there still was an overlay. I expected to get pretty close to 6 million. I think a push that we're making is going to help them out. But Survivor's definitely going to hit it. You got 10 entries there. And, you know, with Survivor, there's just so many ways to get out early of this contest. And that's why you almost need more entries in a way. Well,
so many people do like the max in the Survivor opposed to the max in the million. It's not even close, you know. And then you're talking about twice as many entries you can do as a max in the Survivor. So we'll have somebody do 1 million and 10 survivors, or 2 million and 5 or 10 survivors or whatever. But they're going to do way more survivors than they do millions, and that's reflected in the numbers so far. It's like it's a little better than 2-1, like I said, but like when it comes down to it, it's going to end up being like 3-1, closer to 3-1.
You know,
all said and done.
Let's talk about the true numbers. 992 right now for millions out of 6,000 needed. So almost, you know, 1/6 of the way there, I guess. And then 2,122 out of the guaranteed 10 million. And yeah, I expect that to be 2,500 as well, being that we have almost a week left in August. So, or in July. So yeah, we're
in July, right?
That's the current numbers. Get down to Vegas, man. It is well worth it to get in these contests. So next question with me, I always wonder about college contests. I always wish that there's college. I'm a huge college football fan. I just wish that they could make the software for it, because I think even if Derek threw out a 500,000 guarantee, meaning 250 to first, it'd be enough for me to throw in 1,000 to get in the contest, you know, and then just kind of see how it grows. Because once I'm out there signing up for millions, I might as well sign up for the college one too. I wish it was there, but a couple years ago, William Hill did one, but I doubt they're doing one again, right?
No, they're not touching it. They're done. They lost so much money in those couple years that you were doing it that, because they guaranteed $1 million 1 year and then 500 the next, 500,000. And yeah, they took a bloodbath on it. So it didn't really work out too well for them. They paid out the top 10. Was it a good contest? I mean, it was the only contest, the only pure college contest in town. And you had to pick from only 30 games. I think that's the biggest challenge when it comes to college football contests, is just that, what kind of a pool of games do you draw from? Because games are played almost every single day of the week. Once you get out of that first month of the season, you've got games on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So how do you set that up where you're not excluding certain conferences or, you know, I don't know. That to me, it's not so much the software as it is just the logistics of doing a contest, is that that there's games every day of the week, and what do you pick and what do you not pick as far as available for the pool?
Yeah,
so William Hill did it. They did like the 30 games, and they were all Saturday games. So you had to have your picks in, and they tried to schedule the games where if you could still pick seven games like afternoon Pacific time. You know what I mean? So it was the only real game in town as far as a pure college football contest. So they try to get people in it. And trust me, I've talked to people around town trying to talk them into it. We met with Jay Cornegay over at the Westgate after the season to try to say, hey, if you guys want to try to bring more people in the super contest, like, why not do a college contest? Because I thought you could get between 500 and 1,000 entries. And not only are you getting people to sign up for that contest, but what Derek did with the Survivor contest is it's bringing people in for the Survivor contest, and then they sign up for the million while they're there. There's a guaranteed prize pool, which is a huge advantage as well and selling point. But the Survivor contest is what has really gotten the million to grow. It's just that you're gonna go to one stop and sign up for both contests.
I agree with you. I think you should do that. You know, I would definitely go to the Westgate when I'm coming up there for contest weekend. The 22nd through the 25th, I'll be there of August. But I would certainly take an Uber to the Westgate to get in the college contest.
Yeah, a lot of people would do it, and that was kind of the selling point. It was like, how do you save the super contest or kind of help it out, you know, with the signups? Because the numbers have been dwindling the last few years. They had a spike right after COVID year, because how do you not go up from 2020? 2021 was higher, and then 2022 and 2023 have been progressively lower. So there was only 1,100 entries in that contest last year.
Yep.
And, you know, I don't know what the pace is over there now, but I mean, they'll be lucky to probably get the same number this year or break 1,000. And that's not something you want to have for like what was once the most prestigious contest in town.
I didn't mind the 30 on Saturday, to be honest, but that's the best way you can do it. I mean, maybe you have the one on Sunday they have once in a while, but which is only really in the beginning of the season. And
yeah,
I think it made sense. It's a shorter year though. It is shorter, but hell yeah.
Yeah.
While I'm there, I might get on the super contest too. Yeah. It's just, you're right.
I think they should have done that. The William Hill contest was only 10 weeks. So they didn't even really go deep into November. It was like basically the first week, I think, in November or two.
Right.
And then once you got the rivalry games and things like that, and there were no bowl games or anything,
they missed the first week. They missed week one of college football. It was,
yeah, they missed week because they start with the NFL like week one, so that the timing wise, right. So it's basically like I think you're even into week two. So there's week zero, week one, week two. It's almost like into that week two, like traditionally. So yeah, I mean you're just limiting the amount of games, and let's be honest. I mean, Circa doesn't need another contest. Can they do another contest? Sure. But logistically, I mean, why do they need to bring more people in with another contest when they're already getting all they could probably ask for outside of hitting that 6,000 in the Circa million, which I know they're going to go hard to do this year. It's just another contest to try to have to manage. And those things are not easy. I mean,
totally.
You have to be able to get people signed up, get the rules out, get the, you know, make sure that people know how they work and the ins and outs of the contest, and then I have to, you know, try to promote them on top of them. They already have the two best contests around. There's not, they don't need to try to have it.
Agree. And that's why it makes more sense for the Westgate to do it. I totally agree.
Or there was someone else. I mean, William Hill, it was, you know, it still brought them into the books.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
To sign up.
Yeah.
But
yeah. And they're not even owned by an American company. William Hill is a European company.
Correct. Yeah.
And so that's,
they're Caesars now. So that's part of it too. They spent a lot in redoing their app and getting that their name
at the time
there.
It was, yeah. And then it became Caesars around that time. And that's what they were focused on. But last question, what time are the entries due for each contest, and how you set this up for your clientele?
Sure. So we do have two options. We have people choose between a Friday and a Saturday deadline. And what we do, we try to do that because some people know their picks right off the bat. We've got so many people who just submit their picks within that first like 30 minutes, even not even picking the Thursday game. When those lines come out Thursday morning, they're ready to roll and they just want to put them to bed. They've been looking at the openers from Sunday night after the previous week's games. And they look at the line movement, or they just feel like they have
screw injuries. Let's just throw them in.
Yeah. So like, yeah, it's a lot different than when COVID was happening, where you had to rely more on the injury reports and who's in and who's healthy, all that kind of thing. Yeah, our deadlines are 1 p.m. Pacific time on Friday and Saturday for Circa and 4 p.m. Pacific time for the Super Contest. So we do offer the latest deadline out there of any service for Circa, which is the 1 p.m. Pacific time. That's the latest we could possibly do to help our clients out, make sure we get everything put to bed before they need to be in at the sports book. It gives us a little cushion to try to get everything in. Because, yeah, dealing with 1,000 clients, and I think we had, I'm trying to think how many, like 2,500 entries in the Circa contest last year, something like that between the two, maybe even more, like between 2,500 and 3,000 entries we were responsible for putting in. So we got to make sure that, because most people do take the Saturday deadline because it gives you the most time to get those picks in. So we got to make sure that we have enough time to put them in after we give you guys as much time as possible.
Absolutely.
So,
and I think that's a fair time.
One advantage to using us is we'll give you the most time possible.
1 o'clock is a fair time. That is great stuff, Matty. Thank you so much for coming on and breaking it down. Where could our listeners and viewers get your information to get into these contests?
Well, yeah, footballcontest.com's got everything you need to succeed, as we say. We go, we think the experience matters when it comes to picking a proxy, and that's why we want you to go with the pros, which is me and Toni. We want you guys to just again focus on picking the winners, and we'll do the rest. We'll take the other stress out of it, so you don't have to. You can rest easy at night. But yeah, we've got all the information on all the contests, the big contests in town. We'll keep you posted on our Twitter feed, which is also at Football Contest. So check that out as well. We'll give you updates on how many entries are in each of the contests and kind of go from there. But we appreciate you having us on as usual and look forward to seeing you there at the end of August.
All right. Well, thank you so much for coming on. Make sure you guys check out footballcontest.com. Get into these wonderful Circa Million, Circa Survivor, obviously Westgate, or any other contest that they will proxy for. Thank you so much for listening to this podcast. I hope you found the information valuable. Make sure you get into the Las Vegas contest at the Circa, where you have the guarantees, or the Westgate, or any other contest with footballcontest.com. Have a great rest of your week, and go get some winners.